Hey guys, Defcon here. We are continuing the second part of Act 8. In the last episode we did the right side and did our labyrinth run. If you haven't seen that, be sure to check that out. We will now do the left side of Act 8, the promenade. I always do the right side first, I don't know why, just do. So we now have our Bane of Legends. It will be great. Destroy everything. Get these attack speeds and little onslaught buff when you kill a rare or unique enemy. Pretty nice. There is one. Nice. Still don't have a freeze removal flask. This is something we could do in the future. But we are tanky, so we are tanky. Were his last words, you know. Get these freeze removal for your strong boxes. Just don't be stupid like I am. Kill them all. Boom boom boom. Yeah, these for these rares we need more damage. Okay, we could do our Blood Rage, I keep forgetting this. Gives us even more damage and attack speed. So let's activate it. So there is the bathhouse. I also have a very specific way of clearing these. Who would have thought? I mostly do Hugo last because I just don't like him and I want to be as tanky as possible. That's it for that. So you walk through here and soon meet this this madman charging you. Here he is. But he's already gone. Get the quest item. I'm not sure, but I guess we can do Hugo. Yes, we can. This is the trial. We can do that pretty quick. Pretty quick. Lever here. Lever there. Lever here. Recipe. Lever there, lever there. Lever here. Okay. What am I doing? I'm stupid. Here. Let's be quick with this. Okay, nice. So then I guess we are just going down and doing Yugel later. Because we are already on this track and we are not going back. Oh. Lunaris Concourse. Here you have to go up. From the waypoint, just go up and you, like in Act 3. Basic stuff. When do you think are we dropping our 5 link? Has to be soon, hasn't it? And we are not finding any 200 weapons. What's up with that? Our drop is ready. Return to the guard. And we nearly really have to go harvesting, but I will do this probably later. I don't know if this is something that is interesting for you, me just doing a harvest for 15 minutes. You could tell me in the comments below if it's something you'd like to see, you know, the actual harvesting and crafting afterwards. I always think this is not so enjoyable for you. So, good. It's a bit laggy here. Lunaris Temple. Already forgot our blood rage. Have to think about getting this in. So much seeds. Yes, I know, Oshabi, I'm sorry. I'm just sorry. So, left or right? I'll go right, like I said, always right. That's just the basics to Path of Exile, always go right. And max your resist and get life nodes. This is Path of Exile. And it was a lie. Or was it? Yes, it was. What's up if you die? So... nice. Boom, boom, boom. There's an exile. She used to be hard. But she isn't anymore. We get the waypoint. Go down. Kill stuff. I know I'm repeating myself, but it is going really good. I am, of course, slower than most of people because I'm recording and commentating and stuff, but I am having fun. And I'm sure some of you guys want to play Earthquake and are not sure what the gameplay looks like, and so in a few days I'm going to have the whole campaign on video and maps, and some of these watchstones and this, all this stuff. I hope I can make a good video about that, and when I get this character high enough to explain to you how this works. Alva, don't bother me. You know I don't like you. Why are you so persistent? Get this. Destroyed! Nice. Always go right, like I said. Yeah, it's a lie. So, it's probably up. No, it's not. Oh, is it? No, it's not. Good. So much density here, huh? So much monsters. Crazy. Pity I have to kill all of them. So... up and left, this is really not my thing. Through these doors, like in Act 3, you already know this. It is pretty basic stuff. And when the door was on this side, it's mostly why can't I lead slam here? Ah, yeah. It's mostly going to be the right angle, the same angle as the first door, you know? This seems to be the way. Nice. Kill them all. Ooh, get the noble axe. Hit this guy and get our orb. He's not that scary. He has a shotgunning attack where he gets many arrows out, but apart from this, he's a douche. So, we are now selling our stuff and are doing Yugel in the bathhouse. We skipped him here. What is it? And then this was it with this axe. Get our respect point here. Oh. Taking this. Oh, it wasn't even a respect point. It was a jewel. The bathhouse. So, Yugel, it will be to the left. We will go back the way we came, or already went through. Oh. Look how many mobs we let there live. And it's here to the left. Pretty much always the same. Okay. In the high gardens, be a little bit careful of the cold porcupines. These guys here. They do much damage. I have a little bit of armor and fortify, you know, but if you're just a caster, for example, playing a spell slinger and you're killing the whole screen and these spikes come flying at you, could be that you have problems, but yeah, best thing. How are even many are playing spell slingers or the good old trickster. What's with bow characters? You can play bleed bow with character. That would be something I would be interested in. But what's with normal bow attacks, you know? Lightning arrow, good old stuff. Can you play this still? Or elemental hit, for example. Yeah, but bleed bow gladiator, that would be also something I would be interested in. And what I was thinking about was, you know, the jewel, your hollow palm technique, where you are unarmed and don't have gloves on, or just have gloves on, I'm not sure how it works. You know, like a monk hitting everything, also pretty good.
Die rather well.
Yeah, they do. Oh, you're so right, Duelisti. Orb of Alchemy, very nice. Take this, maybe. Or I just let it be laying there. So, the Pools of Terror. He can be tough. He does good damage when he charges or jumps at you. And he's slowing you, yeah, discharge. And these balls also can do a good amount of damage. After they pass you, they do like this exploding attack. This is not so good either. Kill these minions. And then hit him, he will probably go away now again. Circle this. Kill his guys. There he is. Get a cull real soon. Hey, I said get a cull real soon. That's what I'm talking about. Can we change our pantheon? What is this? No, what do we have here? No. Aktes.
What is it?
Sell our stuff.
Watch yourself.
Can we get skill point here? Yes. Just do a life wheel. And then we are off finishing this act. Pretty good. Pretty good stuff. Well, what do you think? Where am I? Yes. We're just going down. And there will be the entrance to the bridge, the harbor bridge. And then we will go down here. Alva. Okay, we can do some Alvas. It's level 60 now. Don't get. Hey guys, I wanna do Alva.
Hello.
So, no, here. What is this? Explosive charge, take down, and then get this open. So you do upgrade the room that you kill the guy in. Up is always upgrade and down is a change. And the more monsters you kill, the more time you have. And yeah, you need these stones to open these doors. We will open this. They're really tanky. So clear these guys. We need a few levels anyway. Boom, boom, boom. Wow, the sound. Boom, boom. But the mob density is pretty nice. I have to admit that. So, there are a few guys hiding here. But I guess that's it. Good stuff.
Good job.
Okay, shitty unique.
Good to see you survived your first incursion.
Yeah, we did, didn't we? So, let's do this. Oh, what the hell? Let's go in here. Movement speed, elemental equilibrium. Really nice zone with the blood rain and the blood zone. Really nice. Really nice. He does a bleed attack, but he is already dead. Okay. Pretty quick stuff. Yeah. There's another incursion. Let's do this. But I don't know if we will do all of them in this zone, because we are going straight to the boss room. Pits. Sacrifice unique item, then do down. Because we wanna enter. And because we want to connect it to the entrance. Ooh, yeah. Kill them all. Much damage, much wow here. Incursions can be also a little bit difficult, because there are sometimes these poison spitters in here, and they you enter the incursion and they all attack you. Can be scary. Connect the entrance, actually click on it, and connect the other room. Where is it? Top left, yeah. Vaults. Pretty good. Okay, we have sacrificed chamber, the tunnels. Okay. Take the pilot forever. continue. Boom, boom, boom. So, let's go in here. Activate this. You need the quest items we collected here. And at first they will fight each other, but then they will realize that we are the shit in here and will attack us. They will change from time to time. Just circle them, get our fortify. Be careful of the fire damage. Am I saying and standing directly in it? So you're going down. First one down. You will come now. The color is just so nice, isn't it? So, we are probably changing our Pantheon. I don't know if you want to take the stun one. Yeah, we take this for the big hits, you know. Let's go to Blood Aqueduct and go to town. We will travel to Highgate this episode. Will be a quick one. Kill a few enemies. And then we are already getting there. Act 9. Act 9 takes a while. Maybe need two parts for it, not sure, but there's quite some things to do there. We haven't changed one gear piece in quite some time. So there's... now that the zones are getting higher, we can get better items. I think we will get new upgrade soon. Good. We can also go delving when we want in the near future. And we do have a crap load of harvesting to do and arranging our garden. Yeah, good stuff. But this will be for future episodes. You can probably tell me again in the comments below if you want to see more delving and the incursion stuff and harvesting. If that's something you would like to see now and then, or if you think, nah, I want to see him get through maps and do the real endgame, you know? Not do this shit. Nobody has time for that. Okay. So, thank you very much, guys, for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, consider joining the channel, smashing the like button, leave a comment, what you will. I'll see you guys next time, and hearts for everybody.